Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about exit lag. Basically, it's a website or a slash application that helps you with your games and your overall performance in the games. So let's talk about it briefly. So exit lag helps you with your FPS boost and your internet performance and so on. So for example here, with exit lag on, you'll see that it works perfectly without no lag and perfect and smooth experience. But when you close the exit lag, you'll find that it will become laggy. That person or the other opponent, you find that he is more laggy, he's got more time to react, and his ping is very high and his FPS may be even low. So that's the difference between exit lag open and closed. So it helps. Here's a lot of games. You have a lot of games that are supported with exit lag, and a lot of more games that are added every day. So what does basically exit lag does? It automatically optimizes your connection, your Wi-Fi slash Ethernet, or it depends on what you're using. It will optimize it so it can work with all games. Customized settings for hardcore gamers and desktop account also works for the mobile version, because exit lag has another mobile version for mobile gamers, and also support team is ready always to help. So there's also a FAQ website for them, but it's okay. So let's create or get exit lag. First, you're going to click here on get exit lag. It will open here. And you'll have the subscription plans. So there is a monthly subscription plan, annual and quarterly. So every 3 months, every month or every year. The every month is around $6.50. I see that as a very good price compared to it being a very good application. It really boosts your performance and it really gets you to the point of gaming. I really recommend that. There's an annual also and quarterly, so $5 and $4.50, depends on what you want. You can choose any of those. Okay, and you can create your own account and choose your payment method. After all of this, you're going to get an email with the confirmation and your .exe folder to set up your exit lag application on your Windows device. So here you're going to open the setup, click yes, and it will welcome you to the exit lag setup wizard. Click next. It's going to tell you which is your destination location where you would like to download the application to. You browse here and then click next. It will ask you if you want a desktop shortcut, which we actually want, so click next. And it will ask you where to install. It will show you the overview of what you're going to do. Then click next. It will extract files and so on. Wait for it. And waiting, so it's done, and click finish. This is the last thing. Now you will have to restart your computer so the application can work. So click here on restart. Now after you restart your computer, go down here into the search bar and search for exit lag and click open. It will open the application here. So exit lag, enter your email with the account that you already logged in. So you could have already created an account using the website, and click login to exit lag. So it will log in. And it will analyze all routes to other regions or even your home country region, so it can stabilize and establish a connection to them if you want to when connecting your games to exit lag. So welcome to Exitlag. Here's the homepage. You've got all games that are supported by Exitlag, and I want to tell you that it is a lot of games. Okay, you can open and make Exitlag stop, or you can make it work from here. So here's the button for it. You've got tools and accounts, and we're going to talk about it. So tools. First, you're going to get interface language, so English or whatever you want. Start automatically with Windows. So these are the general settings for the thing. So it doesn't need much to know. Here's about the FPS boost. So define maximum processing priority for games, minimum processing priority for system services, so on, game bar, game DVR, core parking, energy efficient Ethernet, because I'm connected to Ethernet, and so on. Traffic cheaper, so never limit only to when proxied connection is slow, and always limit. Multi-internet, so specify network interfaces, diagnostics, so you can monitor your ping in real time. So let's 1 minute, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. So 1 minute is okay. So it will tell you that monitoring is started, gateway, so on. Yep. And new game request if the game that you want to play isn't supported by Exitlag or Exitlag hasn't made a server for it already. Okay, so we're going to click here on home and search a game that I have downloaded. For example, let's search for Roblox and click here. It will tell you the game region which you want. Choose a region where your game server is hosted, so the region that you want to be in when playing. So let's, for example, choose all regions because it's mostly recommended by Exitlag. It will tell you use the routes within my country first. So if you wanted to work only first through your country, then other countries, or you wanted to choose automatically. Redirect login connection. You can also choose that. So yep. Here, let's click on optimize, so it will also analyze the routes that already we did at the beginning when we were doing our application, or when we were opening the application. It will do it again, so we can optimize the routes and everything, all regions to your game. It will load for multiple seconds, yes, and then you're going to click here on apply routes. But there are actually advanced routes here, so to routes TCP and routes UDP. You can choose if you want to, and then click apply. So let's click apply routes. So here, yep, Roblox now is connected to Exitlag, and if you've got already problems, so you have to connect it to the applications slash games that you have problems with. But yep, so now if you had problems with the game which is called Roblox, you will have it work perfectly, easily, very good, high FPS if you show your FPS lags and so on. So let's check out our tools. The Bing diagnostics, yep, so it will tell you the spikes and so on, the average Bing for the internet and the gateway and so on. Spikes, lost packets, last ping, maximum ping, the minimum ping, so on. So that's almost about it about Exitlag. I wish you've liked the video today and liked the tutorial. Please put a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.